being a director is the goal talaga. Yun po talaga end game for me.
Joan Bascon, Donna Cariaga, at Harvey Bautista, bida sa Cinemalayan Film Festival. Know more about Harvey's achievements as an actor and producer. Dito lang sa Star Magic Inside News.
What's up mga kapamilya? I'm Anthony Varian, your ultimate flexmate, and welcome to Star Magic Inside News, ang inyong tropa when it comes to the latest update at exclusive insider info on our favorite kapamilya stars.
Cinemalaya, the country's indie film festival, is back to live on-site screening after 2 years of online screening. This year's festival features 18 independent films that include Angkas, starring Joem Bascon, Donna Cariaga in Retirada, at Harvey Bautista for the movie Blue Room. Bida sa pelikulang Angkas si Joem Bascon, istorya ng isang habol-habol rider mula sa isang secluded na lugar ng Compostela Valley, and about his dangerous journey in helping a childhood friend. Ibang Donna Cariaga naman ang mapapanood natin sa Retirada, a story about a retired government employee who found her new hobby with the hopes of solving her financial problems. Balik-balikula naman ang dating child star na si Harvey Bautista sa isa ring full-length film na Blue Room. The story is about an indie teen band who were arrested for drug possession and about the boys' struggles to get out of their own mess.
We had the chance to talk to Harvey about his acting comeback, his role, and his experience about working on a Cinemalaya film.
It's a story about five teenagers, privileged teenagers, who are also part of a band, Banda po sila. Angalan nila Rebel Rebel. And like I said, they are kind of privileged. They are very privileged. And so, in one night, they get put through the test na parang, are they going to let their morals go para makawala sila sa situation nila? Or are they gonna basically survive the night? Halos parang yun po yung feeling ng movie. If anything, it's a tension movie. It builds tension po talaga. And first time I heard of the movie, my dad po, called me up and he goes, there's a movie that we're producing, read the script, baka interested ka. I read the script po. It was at first, kasi the script went through different drafts. First draft that I had read was the first draft. And it was very different from the movie that you're going to see in Cinemalaya. But from the start, I was already interested in it because it is a band movie. I have an interest in music. And I thought it would be interesting for me na yun nga, parang Cinemalaya nga po, tapos band movie. But as time went on, the script really did progress into something that I didn't expect. It sort of changes genres midway through the movie, which is just in my, you know, when I saw the movie a couple of weeks ago, it just changes tone immediately. But yeah, I did the audition. I went through an audition. This wasn't just given to me on a plate. First, I had to work for it. Nag-audition po ako dati maan, first time I met her. And it went well naman. A year went by and we started shooting with Elijah Canlas, Nurjun, Keoni Jin, Juan Carlos, si Sir Bombi Plata, and Jerick Arceo. Cast namin is great. It was a fun time. And it was honestly one of the best experiences I've had on a set because I was able to form a parang family na rin po. It was very interesting because the shooting process was like, okay, rehearsal, take, next scene, which is usually how taping goes. During the shoot, there was this flow of parang creativity among the cast and the director. It was a collaborative process between us, and it was so much fun, I guess, for an actor like me who's starting out pa lang, alam mo yun, to be able to experience an environment na is so welcoming to improv and so welcoming to new ideas. It was a very fun shoot for me, and I'm very proud of the movie that we were able to make. And we were able to talk with Direk Maan about characters. And she basically told me that Chigs has this insecurity. So he has this insecurity about losing his music or losing his bandmates. Insecurity about himself, but insecurity about siguro anxious din na mawawala yung music sa kanya. So I guess I relate to him in a way na parang I cling onto filmmaking or storytelling the way that Chigs hangs on to music. Siguro yung passion ni Chigs and for music is sort of the same as mine for music. Siguro pre-project ko na lang rin yung idea na yun into Chigs. But yeah, I relate to him in that way. That one of the themes is the use of platform and social media. And dito po sa mga these days po, social media is a very big platform. You can either use it to rise people up, or you can use it to bring it down. Or you can stay neutral and not do anything, not help or not, you know, just stay neutral in topics and such. And I think this movie sheds light on how important it is to be a creator and having a platform and not really using that platform properly, you know. And it definitely is for the youth, I would say.
Aside from Blue Room, Harvey is also a movie producer at the age of 18. He co-produced one of Gawad Alternativo's Pagbilang Kong Tatlo under his own production, Calle Sagrada. The said movie is considered his passion project. The young actor admits that his love for the arts is something that he got from his father, Herbert Bautista, and the Bautista clan.
Directing po talaga is my goal. I really want to direct po talaga. And yun nga, like I said, I love doing what I do. I love being an actor. But I also love filmmaking in general. You know, I think I love the whole process behind it. And yeah, I mean, being a director is the goal talaga. Yun po talaga endgame for me. The most fulfilling, I guess, is the process of, you know, pinaplanan niyo po yung production, pinaplanan niyo po yung wardrobe ng characters, yung treatment ng pelikula. Tapos, isushoot niyo na, makikita niyo na yung characters na mabubuhay bigla sa mga actors niyo. And it's just the whole process of creating a film, from writing the script, doing the wardrobe, shooting the film, and editing it. There's something about that process that feels parang unreal. Kasi this is something that you created, you know. A few weeks ago, it was nothing. It didn't exist. Now, 1 week later, it exists. You have the film. All that's left is to edit it. Tapos papakita niyo sa mga tao. And yeah, I guess another fulfilling part is seeing people be so proud of the film, especially the writer and director. I hope for Calle Sagrada, mag-expand pa po yung prod house namin. Yung po talaga yung hope ko. I hope that we expand to episodic features naman po. Sana makagawa po mo ng series. And I just want to be a director and writer who just makes films po. Filmmaking is my passion po talaga. Aside from filmmaking, I hope I get to do more interesting roles as an actor po in the future. I guess as an actor, I want to challenge myself. I want to be better at what I do. I want to be better as an actor. Hopefully my career goes somewhere.
Why not?
Hopefully my directing and acting career goes somewhere. Right? Very supportive naman to my parents ko, which is something I'm very thankful for. I mean, like we said po nga kanina, di ba? Nasa dugo po namin. Sa lolo ko, director, datay ko, nag-artista, mo naman po, artista. Yeah, I mean, nasa dugo po talaga namin eh. And they are very supportive about it. Very cautious about it din po. Kasi yun nga, school ko po, dapat focus din po ako dun. But yes, I am very thankful that they're very supportive of what I do. What I'm passionate about.
Wow! I'm glad you're doing what you love, Harvey. Keep up the good work. I also want to congratulate my fellow Star Magic artists who are a part of this year's Cinemalaya Film Fest. Thank you for watching, mga kapamilya! Abangan ang iba pang mga videos about exclusive at may iidin na balita dito lang sa Star Magic Inside News. Ako po pala si Anthony Barion, your ultimate flex mate. Don't forget to be great because there's greatness in all of us. See you!